fabulous people that put this show on, and one of these fabulous people standing right beside me. I want you to put your hands together for the president of the Kitchener Blues Festival, Mr. Rob Berkshire.
Thank you so much, thank you so much. So I'd like to say a couple of quick words. We all know and love Mel Brown here in Kitchener. And in 2003, the festival decided to give Mel an award, which at the time was the Kitchener Blues Festival Award. Right after that, we asked Mel, and he was very kind and allowed us to put his name on the festival. So it's now called the Mel Brown Blues Award. And we're delighted to be here today with David Wilcox, who's our recipient. And for all you Kitchener folks, we're also delighted to have Miss Angel Brown here amongst us on the stage. And now I'd like to have Mayor Barry Brabandich say a few words.
And to electrum, hello Kitchener! Is everyone having a good time? So one thing that Rob didn't say is this year is the 20th anniversary of the Kitchener Blues Festival. And so on behalf of the council, I want to say thank you to Rob, to all of the hundreds of volunteers, the sponsors, everyone that have made this festival happen since 2001. Let's give all of them a round of applause. And Rob, I'd like to present you with your certificate before you go on to the award.
All right, thank you so much, Barry, much appreciated. I'd like to introduce Mr. Kent Dunbar. He's our announcer down at the YNC stage, and he is going to present the award to Mr. Wilcox.
Yes, a pleasure, absolute pleasure. David, if I get any of this wrong, just throw something at me, okay? All right, so David grew up in a household where his mom played polka music. So I figured that was a kinship with Kitchener because we are the capital of polka, right, for Canada? So in his late teens, he was in the Toronto Yorkville scene, doing folk, doing bluegrass, and playing around until he heard Robert Johnson. Yes, and then he started to grow an affinity for the blues. Now David's first big break came when he got an audition for and was successful in joining the Great Speckled Bird, which was Ian and Sylvia Tyson's band. Yeah, and he had big shoes to fill. He had Amos Garrett, who was the guitarist in the band at that time, he had to fill his shoes. So that was hard for David, but he definitely grew into that. He stuck around with Great Speckled Bird for about 2.5 years, 2 albums. Then he wanted his career to grow beyond that. So he started doing some work with Maria Muldaur, and Maria played here at the festival in 2009. And after a couple of years of that, he decided he wanted to go solo and really grow his career, grow that ability to be able to sing, grow that ability to be able to actually solo more and grow his craft. So in 1978, he recorded his first album. No record company wanted it. No record company wanted it because disco was big. And is Mr. Wilcox disco?
No!
He is not disco. It took until 1980, a small label picked him up.
He's rap.
No, he's not rap either. And that album started to gain traction, and of course it gained traction, right? Because on that album was Bad Apple, Do the Bearcat, Hypnotizing Boogie, Hot Hot Papa, right? That was 1980, 3 years later, Sony signed him. Sony signed him, and the next album, which was My Eyes Keep Me in Trouble, which I love that title. I'm not really sure what it means, but I love that title. That had Downtown Come Uptown and Riverboat Fantasy on it, right? And he kept working hard, he kept recording, and his crowd and fan base grew. Look at this. Look at this. David has a passion for music that you see every time you see him on the stage, right? That comes out. It is actually contagious. His passion for music comes out. And his fans know it. You guys see it every time he hits the stage. The other thing that I love about him is that he has a great sense of humor, and you see that on stage as well. He's also one of the best guitarists you will ever see. Am I correct in that? A 2014 album entitled Guitar Heroes, which captured a live show from Vancouver. So an album called Guitar Heroes 2014 had David on it, Amos Garrett, who he replaced, Albert Lee, and also James Burton, who played with Elvis. That is out of print, but if you guys can grab a copy of that, I gotta tell you, it's worth listening to for sure. So, past Mel Brown Award winner Holger Peterson is called David one of Canada's most original artists. You guys agree? This year will be, right now, will be his sixth appearance at the Kitchener Blues Festival, and somehow that doesn't feel like enough, does it? Right? Six is not enough. It is my absolute pleasure to be a part of this, and I just want to say congratulations, David, on the Mel Brown Award. In addition to that, we also have, someone has a watch, a Volvo watch, inscribed, and this is from John Anthony Jewelers as well, so he gets the Mel Brown Award, a watch, and in moments he's going to play for you guys, so please give it up to the 2022 Mel Brown Award for Mr. David Wilcox!
Very quickly, a great many people, this is a great honor, named after the magnificent Mel Brown, and very, very many people contributed to this. My partner, Dale Williams, the fabulous crews and bands I have the honor of working with, some of whom you'll meet shortly. But most of all, you and people like you, because without you and people like you, there wouldn't be any David Wilcox. So on behalf of all of us, thank you very much. He stole the award. Right back, and we better be good.